I'm Supriya. I'm going to give a brief information about the comparisons between primary and secondary memory with my teammates Akshita and Nidarshan. So firstly, let us know about the meaning of memory. In a computer, memory is just like a human brain. It is used to store data and instructions. The memory system of the computer is one of the most important parts of the computer. CPU uses this memory system to store and read data to give output fundamentally. There are two types of computer memory, primary memory and secondary memory. But what is the primary memory and secondary memory? What are their uses and the types? And how does CPU uses these different types of memories like RAM, ROM and other storage devices? And also how these memories are different from each other? Let's see. There are two different types of memories in computer, primary and secondary. Let's start with primary memory. Primary storage memory plays a very big role in the computer because a computer can't start without primary memory. This type of memory, also called as main memory of the computer, this memory is directly connected to the CPU. So CPU uses this memory directly to retrieve or store data. Primary memory has very fast speed, so accessing data from it is very easy. The main two types of primary memory is RAM and ROM. We'll talk about this in a while. We'll also talk about CPU registers and cache memory, which is also a form of primary memory. Before that, let's get the general idea of secondary memory. Secondary storage or external memory is not directly accessible by CPU. The computer uses its input-output channel to retrieve information from secondary storage into primary memory. So it takes more time to access data from secondary memory than primary memory. The secondary storage, also called as non-volatile memory, because it retains its data even after removing the power supply. Secondary storage devices are important because they store your data permanently until it is overwritten or deleted. In a computer, all of user files and data is stored in this memory. Also, secondary storage devices are very cheaper than primary memory. So usually secondary storage devices have more storage capacity than primary memory, but they are significantly slower to read or write than primary memory because they are not connected to the CPU directly. There are lots of different secondary storage devices like magnetic storage based hard disks, floppy disks which have magnetic rotating disks, semiconductor based SSDs and flash drives which doesn't have any moving parts like hard drives. Further will be continued by Akshita.
Thank you, Supriya. The optical storage based CDs and DVDs, which uses a beam of light to read or write data. Now we have got a general idea of primary storage and secondary storage and how they are different from each other. Let's get a little bit deeper to understand it better. Primary storage is also divided into two categories. They are RAM and ROM, which stands for Random Access Memory and Read Only Memory. RAM is called Random Access Memory because CPU can access any memory cell directly without accessing it sequentially. Now the major difference between RAM and ROM is that RAM uses volatile memory, means that when you power off your computer, the data stored in RAM is erased. So it's also called as temporary. While on the other side, ROM is permanent memory or non-volatile memory. Stored data doesn't change and remains same always because it is only read-only memory and we cannot write them. ROM contains important system files that require for system to boot up, and it also performs major input-output tasks of computer. Different types of ROM includes masked ROMs. These are very first inexpensive hardware devices that contain pre-programmed sets of data and instructions. Another type of ROM is PROM, means programmable ROM. This type of ROM can be modified only once by user and cannot be erasable. They can also not be erasable by UV lights. Another type of ROM is EEP ROM, which means electrically erasable and programmable read-only memory. EEP ROM is programmed and erased electrically. It can be erased and reprogrammed about 10,000 times. Both erasing and programming takes about 4 to 10 milliseconds. Let's see about RAM. RAM is also of different types like SRAM and DRAM, which stands for static random access memory and dynamic random access memory. The difference between these is the way they store data dynamically. We store bits in cells consisting of capacitors and transistor needs to be periodically refreshed, while SRAM retains data bits in its memory as long as power is being supplied and doesn't need to be refreshed because it doesn't contain capacitors. This makes SRAM significantly faster than DRAM. Therefore, static RAM is used to make the CPU cache memory, while DRAM forms the largest system. RAM space. So dynamic RAM is mostly used as primary memory because it is cheaper and have high capacity than SRAM. But this doesn't end here. DROM also have different types, and further will be continued by my teammate Nidarsha.
Storage stores data permanently.